everybody. My name is Austin Moore, and I will be helping kind of host our Boise State Academic Showcase tonight. So this is our academic showcase for our College of Business and Economics and our School of Public Service. And we're so happy that you guys have all chosen to take some time out of your night to learn a little bit more about academics at Boise State and these two academic colleges in particular. Throughout tonight's event, it'll be broken down into a few different sections. So we'll start off just hearing a little bit about major exploration and some of the different academic offerings at Boise State. We do have a Q&A function as part of the webinar. So if you look at the kind of toolbar at the bottom of your screen, you should see a function that says Q&A. Feel free to put any questions that you have into that function throughout tonight's event. We will be addressing those during a live Q&A portion of tonight's event towards the end. So don't be alarmed if you put a question in and you see it might get dismissed or not answered right away. We will get to those questions. We'll actually be answering them live with some of our academic participants and some of our current students, and myself also representing the admission side of things, which kind of leads me into just a little introduction of who I am. So my name is Austin Moore. I am one of our admissions counselors. I work on a great team of admissions counselors who really are here to help students out with the process from maybe starting to consider Boise State as an option all the way up to attending orientation and getting enrolled in some classes and starting, whether it's fall 2023, fall 2024. So if you ever have questions, at the end, we'll also put up the contact for your specific admissions counselor, and we would love to help answer those questions. But before we dive into having some of our academic reps talk about their colleges that they're a part of, I do want to just mention a few things kind of about major exploration and kind of break down some questions that we commonly get in the admissions office. And one of those is the confusion that lies between the academic colleges that make up our academic side of campus, while also just being a Boise State University student. So within Boise State University, we have 7 academic colleges that house all of our majors and minors that we offer. So depending on what you're interested in studying and what you choose to declare as your major, you would actually be a part of one of our academic colleges. And like I mentioned, tonight we're going to be showcasing our School of Public Service, which I am actually a proud 2017 Boise State School of Public Service graduate, got my degree in criminal justice, absolutely love the program. And then we also have our College of Business and Economics. So if you're looking at anything from marketing to entrepreneurship, you're going to get to hear about those opportunities as well. And I know that we have quite a few who are also signed up and in attendance that might be just kind of starting out as undeclared or not quite sure exactly what they want to study. That is absolutely okay. Undeclared is actually our second most popular major for incoming students right now. So majority of our students that are coming in from high school like yourselves are starting out as undeclared, at least at the time of application. And maybe by the time they get to campus or within their first couple of weeks or semester, they're able to kind of figure out what program that they want to pursue. But just know we do have a really great tool called Major Finder, which you can see the link or the URL on the screen, majors.boisestate.edu. This is a great opportunity for you to kind of put in maybe your interests or career goals or graduate school goals. And this will kind of give you a list based on those interests of what majors we have that might be helpful or applicable to whatever you want to do after you earn your undergraduate degree. And then tonight we are joined by, for the School of Public Service, Andy Giacomazzi and Amanda Bull. And then through our College of Business and Economics, or COBE, as you'll hear it called tonight, we do have Kit Scott as well. So with that, I am actually going to be muting myself and turning off my camera and turning it over to Andy Giacomazzi and Amanda Bull through our School of Public Service.
Well, thank you, Austin. Appreciate that. Hi, everybody. I'm Andy Giacomazzi. I'm the Associate Dean for the School of Public Service and also a professor in criminal justice. And I want to also say hi to Amanda Bull, who's our Senior Advising Coordinator. Hi, Amanda.
Hey, Andy. Hi, well, everybody.
Yeah, I mean, great group here. Welcome into Boise, Idaho, by the way. I know some of you are here local and others of you did not experience snow all day today in this beautiful place called Boise. But hopefully many of you will be coming here and experiencing what is a really nice fall and early winter for us here in the Treasure Valley. Amanda and I want to give you the kind of 30,000 foot overview tonight of the School of Public Service, let you know a little bit about our majors and other programs that we have in the hopes that you might be interested in some aspect of the School of Public Service, and then we can follow up with you later and certainly have a chance to answer any questions that you may have in our chat tonight. Let's talk a little bit about our areas of study in the School of Public Service. We have some very traditional majors that you might think of when you think of a School of Public Service. And by the way, Austin mentioned that we are one of seven colleges. To make matters a little bit more confusing, we're a college that's actually named a school. And that has to do with the fact that we are a smaller unit that works in an interdisciplinary way. Our traditional majors, for some of you who may be interested, political science and criminal justice. And we offer pretty large majors there, great faculty members who are really student-centered. And then we have some of our more recent additions to the School of Public Service, environmental studies, as well as global studies, as well as urban studies to complement our undergraduate majors. And then in addition to those majors, we have some certificates and other minors as well that we want to talk about in just a minute. But I want to tell you that the School of Public Service is focused really in an interdisciplinary way. So what we would do as you become interested in the School of Public Service is maybe talk with you about how real world problem solving is typically addressed, not by just one single major or one single discipline, but by multiple disciplines. And the School of Public Service is organized in a way that would allow you to really have a number of interdisciplinary faculty working with you, not only the theories and concepts of the discipline that you're interested in, but also in real world problem solving that involves multiple disciplines. So we're going to encourage you to be thinking about not only majoring in a discipline in the School of Public Service, but maybe thinking about minoring maybe taking one or more of our certificates. And if we can go to the next slide, Austin, I'll have Amanda maybe talk just a little bit about our certificates and our minors.
Yeah, so we have, for each of the majors we have a minor, which is learning about that topic area, but just not as having to take as many classes. So let's say you're interested in doing business as your main major or communication or something like that, but you still have something in the School of Public Service that's sparking your interest. That's where minors can really fit in and pair nicely, that you can still kind of dive into that subject area without having to do all of the requirements of a full major. And so we have one for each of the major areas. And then we also have a military science Army ROTC minor, where students would graduate actually as a second lieutenant in the Army. We also have some branches of political science, like we have political management minor or political communication minor. We have environmental studies, one of our majors, Canadian studies, and then our certificates where you kind of get even a smaller skill set. So let's say you only have 12 credits that you can kind of play around with in your major. That's where a certificate, you can even learn even more of like a narrow scope on a particular topic. And these are really popular at Boise State. We have online options, we have in-person options, with leadership, conflict management, environmental education, human rights, leadership. So all really valuable skill sets for any major and any field of careers that you're wanting to go into.
Our student focus is always to, you know, empower you, the student in the School of Public Service, to become tomorrow's relevant, innovative, responsive, and empathetic leader. So we're always looking for ways to make that happen within your discipline. One of the certificates that Amanda mentioned is applied leadership, which we highly encourage. It's one of our brand new certificates in the School of Public Service. You can take that with any of our majors. And we've designed things so that you're able to do multiple things in the School of Public Service in the 4 years that you may be thinking of wanting to stay at Boise State. So for example, if you're a criminal justice major, we will work with you to add that leadership certificate It doesn't mean that you're going to stay an extra year at Boise State either. I like to use the example in criminal justice because we always try to figure out in the discipline that I am in, you know, why is crime and disorder and fear of crime higher in certain more urban areas than it is in more rural or non-metropolitan areas? To answer that question and to do real world problem solving, as we mentioned earlier, we have to bring in other disciplines to figure that out. That's, again, why we focus on this interdisciplinary learning and why we might encourage you as a criminal justice major to be thinking about urban studies. Urban studies will help you better understand the unique qualities of urbanness and what happens in larger cities that might give rise to fear of crime and disorder and crime. And what are those solutions that we can come up with that might improve quality of life, particularly in those areas that need effective responses to crime and disorder. That's just one example of many examples that we have in the School of Public Service where our majors, minors, and certificates really go together. And we encourage you to be thinking that way as you come into the school. Of course, if you're just interested in a major and want to take a bunch of electives and you know, come out of Boise State with a degree in urban studies or environmental studies, so be it. That's absolutely fine. But we know how expensive colleges and universities are these days. Boise State is, I believe the statistics are the fifth most reasonable state college in the United States. Don't quote me on that, but we're very reasonable. But we still want to make sure that you have the ability to package some things together so that you have multiple degrees and certificates on your transcript when you get out of here in those 4 years or whatever your time frame actually is. Let's move on to the next one, Austin. We want to make sure that you know as well that, you know, like our friends that you'll hear later on tonight in the College of Business and Economics, there's just plenty of support in the School of Public Service. There's plenty of support for you across Boise State University. So once you come in here, you're not just left to your own devices where we might say, hey, just try to figure it out yourself. You got plenty of mentors. We got four in the School of Public Service, four professional academic advisors. These are not individuals who are part-timers, who are kind of here some days and not the other days. These are professional advisors who are here for you that are guiding you through your four-year or more experience. We've got a great set of faculty mentors for you as well. We're very big on hands-on learning, as I mentioned before. In fact, one of our signature initiatives with our brand new dean who's come in this year is really enhancing our experiential learning, which is kind of a strange way of saying we are really interested in you learning beyond the four walls of the classroom. So whereas you may have some great classes with fantastic faculty members where you're getting the theories and concepts of your discipline, we want you to have a signature high educational impact experiential piece under your belt while you're here, where you apply those theories and concepts to the real world. We have urban field schools. We have an environmental studies working lands field school. We've got quality internships. We will work with you to put together something that will allow you to really apply your skills while actually getting academic credit in the School of Public Service. I should mention as well that we are now the go-to college for pre-law. So anybody who might be interested in law school after your bachelor's degree, we have one of our advisors, Haley Johnson, is our pre-law advisor. We have a pre-law society. We're putting together lots of great materials on our website for those of you interested in law school. We're looking at ways of integrating law school admissions testing support services. We just had a pre-law or a law school fair last week in one of our ballrooms in the student union. And so there's a lot more that we are doing as we become the place to go at Boise State for pre-law, in addition to other offices across this university and career services as well that will support all of our students at Boise State. Next one, Austin. Amanda, I'm thinking maybe you can talk just a little bit more about all the different student opportunities that we're highly suggesting our students get involved with, again, beyond the four walls of the classroom.
Yeah, and we'll show you in a second here some of our student profiles to give you kind of an example. But really, as Andy mentioned, that hands-on learning is something that's really valuable in our school and just in any program that you're doing here at Boise State. How can you connect what you're learning in the classroom to also problem solving in the real world, you know, getting employers to look at your application, getting law schools to look at you, graduate schools, stuff like that. And a lot of that is like, what makes you stand out in addition to strong academics? And so that's where we have these hands-on experiences from internships or working with someone in the Treasure Valley, working with different organizations. You can do research projects with faculty members. We have independent studies with faculty. A lot of our students will study either abroad, or you can actually do an exchange where you kind of just hop to another university in the US. So maybe we had a student who wanted to go to University of Hawaii for a semester. So we just kind of swapped her out and she went there for a semester and got to have that experience and still have it all count to her degree here at Boise State. We do field schools, which Andy talked about a little bit, tons of clubs and honor societies and student organizations within our school, but then also across Boise State. So as Austin said earlier, it can be a little confusing to navigate. We have great opportunities in our school. College of Business, which you'll hear from, has great opportunities. Every college has their own, but then there's also, you can be involved across campus as well into ones that welcome any major. And so just really getting involved. We have a living learning community as well, which really helps you get connected that first year because you actually live with people who really want to kind of learn the same skill sets you do. And ours is leadership and engagement. It's just a really cool way to kind of connect that first year. If you might be a little nervous, you know, maybe you don't live in Idaho and you want to just kind of connect to some people, or maybe you already live here, but you want to connect to some new people in the same period of life that you're in with same interest areas. And so we can help you just connect on campus in that way. So really just tons of things to do. And we highly recommend checking those out along with taking classes.
And it's not just a matter of things to do. I love the way that Amanda put it, but we also have decades worth of actual research that shows that the most successful students at a university and college are the ones that actually get involved in university life. So we're highly encouraging wherever you go. We hope you're coming to Boise State, but remember that wherever you're going, don't do like I did as a freshman at the University of California in Irvine. I know we got a lot of Californians with us tonight. Don't just go to class and then go back to your dorm room or, you know, your apartment and do your homework. Do your homework, certainly, but take advantage of everything that's going on or as much as you possibly can within university life. You make those connections, those really, really important connections that are going to help you through to graduation and beyond. So please remember that. And, you know, you're going to meet in just a few minutes here, Maddie and Riley, with a ton of experiences that they have beyond the four walls of the classroom. But we wanted to just show you in the next couple of slides here, some students, some real life students who have majored in School of Public Service programs. But take a look, I won't read this to you, but take a look at some of the different pieces of academic life that they were involved in beyond a classroom setting. Again, I can't stress that enough. Will, as a criminal justice major, just graduated. He was involved in Greek life when he was a fraternity president. We've got a vibrant Greek life at Boise State. Great leadership opportunities there. Look at Carla as a political science major in international relations and comparative politics. She worked in housing and residence life as a residence assistant during a couple of years of her time at Boise State and found valuable leadership experiences there as well. Next one, if you would, please, Austin. And then there's Kate, who is one of our global studies majors. She worked in our writing center, participated in a bunch of research projects in the College of Innovation and Design. Morgan, who is an environmental studies major. And look at, I just want you to see on these programs of study, every one of our students has figured out ways of also adding additional pieces to their major to really stress that interdisciplinarity that is so important in real world problem solving. She got an internship, Morgan did, at the Bureau of Land Management, one of the most prestigious internships that we actually have in the School of Public Service. So that's the 30,000 foot overview. I hope we didn't inundate you with way too much information. Here's some career outcomes, by the way. Those are always things that we want to make sure that we connect our educational pieces to our early careers as School of Public Service students. Feel free to ask more about this as well. But I can tell you, as you read this list under our majors, that you can really make what you want with our majors. They don't tie you into one particular thing. Urban studies, for example, from urban planning to historic preservation to equity program analyst, community outreach, and you can see the variety of careers that our students over the last few years have gone on to achieve since their graduation. So anyway, that's the basic overview of the School of Public Service. Happy to answer your questions, but I do want to turn it over to our colleagues over in the College of Business and Economics and Associate Dean Kit Scott. Kit?
Thank you, Andy and Amanda. That's a tough act to follow, but I hope that I can share some good information with you on the College of Business and Economics. We affectionately call ourselves COBE. And I'll frame what we're going to talk about with respect to our mission statement. And our mission statement is that COBE at Boise State University creates societal impact by inspiring purpose, growing people, creating knowledge, and powering innovation. And as a student here, you'll have the opportunity to grow, to create knowledge, not just get knowledge. You'll have the opportunity, we hope, to find purpose in what you're going to do once you leave the university. And then we're always trying to be on the cutting edge in terms of innovation, and that's a university priority as well. So if you want to go to the next slide, this kind of falls under the inspiring purpose, growing people and creating knowledge. It covers all three. These are our undergraduate programs. And you can see there the degrees are broken down into three different areas. We have most of our degree programs fall under the Bachelor of Business Administration. BBA is the degree. And then underneath that, there are all of these disciplines on the left. And we'll talk about each of those here in a second. Bachelor of Arts, we have a couple in terms of our Bachelor of Arts degrees within the College of Business and Economics, and one Bachelor of Science degree. But let's go back to the BBA degrees. And the reason these all fall under the same category of BBA is that when students come in, they come in as pre-business. And the goal with that is so that students can get put their toe in the water of a bunch of these disciplines on the left and try to get an idea about what's interesting and what they gravitate towards and what's interesting to them, so they can make a better decision about what major they end up going to. Now, we do always have students who know they want to go into finance, and they come in, they do their pre-business for the first 2 years usually, and then they change their major to finance. But if you know you want to do business, but you kind of want to see what the options are, you have that time frame in those first couple of years where you're pre-business, you're not locked into anything, and everything you do during that time, you are applicable to all of the BBA degrees. So I'm looking at the chat question from Paige there. She's actually put the link in there. So that's a good thing. But what those are things like we have our micro and macro economics classes. We have our cost accounting and managerial accounting classes. We have a very biz 101, right, that does in the class cover each of the disciplines as well. Now, as we go through these degree programs, I want to focus on a few because they might, it might not be as obvious. You know, I don't mean to pick on the accountants, but accountancy is pretty straightforward. Finance is kind of straightforward. And I'll talk a little bit later about the careers that each of these degrees leads to. Human resource, you know, that's, you go into a human resource department. But there are a couple that are kind of vague here. So I want to touch on those. Business administration. This is our main management degree. So we used to call it general business. Now, to be more professional, we call it business administration. But this is a general management degree that's applicable across lots of different careers, lots of different disciplines and industries. A lot of our business administration graduates go on to do things in the finance world or in the marketing world, even though their degree is not specifically marketing or finance. And it is one, I think it's our biggest major within the College of Business and Economics. The next one, business economics, you can see we have a couple of degrees here that are economics. So we have the two in the BA, we have the BS that has the word economics in it, and then we have business economics over here. The two BA degrees and this business economics degrees all lead to kind of similar positions, which we'll see on a slide coming up. The business economics one, though, has that pre-business focus to it. So that, you know, a lot of times the BA and BS economics folks will go into government jobs or even some of the jobs that Andy talked about from the School of Public Service, whereas the business economics ones may go into more of a private sector place. Information technology management, that's my home department. I'm a clinical professor of IT management. And you might think to yourself, you know, I'm into technology, I'm into computers, I'm going to go to computer science. And that's great. And if that's, you know, what works for you, that's awesome. IT management in the College of Business and Economics is applying technology to solve problems, to solve business problems. And computer scientists do that as well. But computer scientists are looking at the technology itself, where IT management folks would be looking at how to deploy certain software to achieve certain ends in an organization. And so it's got a mix of technology and management, and there's, it's kind of a range of those skills that we teach in that class or in that major. Management, this particular degree is our online degree completion program. So if you're a transfer student or you build up enough credits while you're here and then you want to do something that's purely online, this management degree completion program is purely online. Along with that, we have this resort operations and hospitality management degree. That's an emphasis area within that online management program. This is a brand new program, but we've developed partnerships with some of the ski areas and some of the hotel organizations in Idaho. And we really hope to spread that out to more regional players like Utah and Oregon and Washington. So that's just started, and I think our first students will be here in the spring for that. And so again, getting to this Bachelor of Science in Business and Economics Analytics, this is our, it's not data science, but it's kind of that business intelligence. How do we take the data that an organization generates and then develop actionable strategy based on the data that we have. How do we take that data and answer a question and then make sure we're serving customers better, for instance? So I'm going to move on to the minors and certificates. We do have, we do have minors in all of our BBA disciplines. Those do require, generally, there's one that doesn't, but those all generally require those pre-business courses to be eligible for. So you would be in finance, for instance, but you might take a marketing minor. For students who are not in the College of Business and Economics, we have a minor and a certificate called Plus Business. And these are foundational business knowledge and skills that are applicable to non-business majors, right? So any of those degrees that the School of Public Service has, if you wanted to give it a business focus, you could take this business, this Plus Business minor or certificate. The minor, I think, is it's at least 12 credits. It might be 15. And then the certificate is the certificate is 12. The minor is 15 or maybe 18 credits. We have a business analytics certificate, which is available to COBE and non-COBE majors. Our business creation certificate is also available to people outside the college. And this is tied to our entrepreneurship management program. And then we also have that certificate in the resort operations and hospitality management. All right, I think we can move on. When we talk about student opportunities, this gets at inspiring purpose and growing the person, right? We have, just like School of Public Service, we have professional, full-time, dedicated advising. And they do more than just make sure you're on track to graduate with your curriculum. They also are, can help you with things that, they can get you in touch with the right person in financial aid or we've had some situations where, we walked with a student over across campus to the Student Union Building to make sure they got in touch with the right office. We have a tutoring lab, and those get at a lot of those pre-business classes like statistics and accounting and ITM. And those are staffed by our graduate assistants. And those, they're just awesome. They really help you understand the material. They're not just helping you pass that assignment or that upcoming exam. They're really there to help you understand the material, and they work through it with you so you can apply that to the situations that are either coming up in your class or in the future as you move into your career. We have a lot of options here. I'm getting the time limit from Paige, so why don't we move on to the next slide. So our career outcomes, we place the vast majority of our students a lot of times when they're still in their senior year. I know in my home department of IT management, we place 94% of our students into careers that are ITM focused within 6 months of graduation. The vast majority of those before they graduate. I'm 100% sure that all of our other degrees are in that similar range. Next slide. The text is kind of small here, but this gives you an idea of if you like to do these things, those would align with the degrees on the left. And then there are some examples of job titles and average wages. These wouldn't be starting wages. So you would work yourself up to some of these, six-figure salaries. But these degrees put you on that path. There are several degrees we offer: accountancy, finance. The economics degrees might put you on the track to be a chief financial officer. The ITM, the supply chain, might put you on track to be a chief information officer, CIO. The business administration, the entrepreneurship, even the marketing might put you on track to be a CEO. And the best thing about all of these majors is they all kind of lead to that place if you want to go there. All right. Do we still have another slide? Okay. Did I get in under my time?
You're good. I appreciate it, Kit.
All right.
Like Paige, and we've been mentioning in the chat, if you do have any questions now that you've heard a little bit about some of our academic programs, please feel free to put those in the Q&A. I'm actually going to also take this time before we jump into the live Q&A portion. We have two students who are here with us, one from each of the colleges who have spoken tonight. So I'm going to let Maddie and Riley each take a minute to just introduce who they are, what they're studying. And Maddie, if you want to start, and then you can kick it over to Riley.
Perfect. Hi, everyone. My name is Maddie. I am a senior this year at Boise State. I'm studying business administration, then minoring in marketing and entrepreneurship. I am from Vancouver, so I'm an out-of-state student, and I lived on campus my first year. While I've been a student on campus, I've gotten involved in things like the Women in Business Club, where we have different panels that we go to and different activities we attend. I am a student recruitment specialist, so I give tours on campus during the week, and I was also an orientation leader this last summer, so helping first-year students come in when they go to orientation before they start as a student. And I've also been able to get a marketing internship on campus. So I have an internship with Boost, which is like a mobile ordering app for dining on campus, which has been really cool. So another way to get involved and use some of what I'm learning in the classroom with different aspects of life on campus. So that's me, but then I'll pass it over to Riley.
Yes, so my name is Riley, and I am a senior studying criminal justice with a certificate in conflict management. I'm also from the Washington area, but instead of Vancouver, I'm from Bonnie Lake. Other than that, I'm pretty involved here on campus. I'm president of my sorority, as well as the women's club soccer team. I'm a Bronco ambassador for the admissions office, as well as for the Bronco shop. I was also an orientation leader. And then with the criminal justice degree, I'm part of like the pre-law society, which helps me kind of go towards the getting into law school route and helping me with that. And then I've also done a few internships. So I did an internship a year ago with a criminal defense attorney. And then since May, I've been mediating people in the Ada County Courthouse.
Awesome. Well, thanks for sharing a little bit about yourselves and what you're involved in. So I know that these are technically academic showcases, but again, if you have just specific questions based on what our current students are involved in outside of the realm of just specific areas of study, please, again, let us know. But with that, I'm actually going to stop sharing my screen, and I'll invite all of our panelists who are here with us tonight to turn on their cameras. That way we can see everybody, and I will be kind of moderating some of the questions that have come in through our Q&A function. And again, we'll be doing this for about 15 more minutes. So if you think of anything, we'll definitely try to work through all the ones that we have. But kind of getting started with the School of Public Service. So either Andy or Amanda, I know you mentioned minors. We got a question asking, if I wanted to do a minor in criminal justice, would that take an additional year to complete? And how does that work with a major outside of the School of Public Service?
That is such an Amanda question that it's not even funny. Amanda, go.
I was like, you turned on your thing. I was like, wow, Andy's feeling confident today. Okay, so that's a great question. And so criminal justice has, let's see, for the minor, 4, 5, 6, 7 classes. And so that's about 21 credits. And so it kind of depends on what major you're doing. And if that major has the elective space, so we call it elective, which is kind of that free space that you can use to maybe study abroad or add a minor or add a certificate. And so if you have a lot of that free space, or maybe you took a lot of stuff in high school, so you've given yourself some free space and you're planning on being here for 4 years, but you could technically graduate in 3.5 and that freaks you out a little bit and you want to be here for the full 4. That's where these minors can work. If you don't have electives or if you do have electives, a minors work really well to still be done in 4 years. Maybe you could do some summer classes if it's going to throw off graduation a little bit, if you do want to do a minor. And so it is pretty feasible to do alongside most majors, but you just want to check with your advisor for your major, maybe your first or second semester, and kind of talk about, this is one of my goals. How do I make that fit? But it really is only going to fill about 21 credits, so about 7 extra classes.
I would also say, too, that we sometimes reverse engineer things and we ask you, you know, what is it that you're really interested in career-wise? If you have that kind of idea, we can help steer you toward majors or minors, not just within the School of Public Service, but also in other colleges as well.
Yeah, like Kit was talking about that minor for business, for non-business majors. Yeah. I helped a student add that today. So we are seeing overlap between the colleges a lot with minors and certificates.
Awesome. Thank you. And from the admission side too, I know Amanda just mentioned if you might have some college credit coming in from high school, just know that we do transfer over those concurrent or running start credits that you've earned. So if anybody's completed some or working on them while still in high school, we'll always, as admissions counselors, we'll send out a little checklist item saying, hey, make sure to have that school send us a transcript. That way, when you come to orientation, we'll be able to hopefully transfer all those credits over and have those on your account. So yeah, just wanted to put that out there. Moving over, Kit, I had a question for you. And this is something that just by me traveling and visiting college fairs, I get a lot, but do you have a formal sports management or sports marketing focus, or what would students choose to pursue that career path?
We do not have a program that is specifically about sports management or sports marketing. However, I would say our business administration degree is probably the most applicable for sports management. And then our marketing degree would be the most specific to sports marketing. And in a lot of our programs like that, a lot of the coursework, especially the upper division, you know, junior and senior level class coursework, gives you the opportunity to bring in those interest areas into class projects. Guest speakers sometimes come in and speak on those things. So it's not outside the possibility that you could still get that flavor in either of those degrees.
Awesome. Appreciate that. And then Maddie and Riley, question for you guys, kind of based on just kind of coming from a similar area, I guess, what led you to Boise State? And then with that, kind of what led you into the majors that you ended up pursuing? And Maddie, if you want to start again, that'd be great.
Yeah, for sure. So coming from Washington, Boise was different enough for me. I wanted that change of a new area and somewhere I could kind of grow and to be myself. But it was still like 6 hours from home. So it was kind of like the perfect distance. But as far as like majors and stuff go, I came into Boise and I really wasn't sure what I wanted to do. I started off as pre-business, but through the different things I've gotten involved in is how I actually figured out that I liked marketing. So like Riley, I'm also Bronco Shop ambassador. So we work with the Bronco Shop. We do like some marketing stuff with them, photo shoot stuff like that. So I realized that was really fun. And then I also was a Bronco ambassador. So giving those volunteer tours, sometimes like on the weekends and stuff. I was through those two things and also running the Instagram for my sorority. I was like, you know what? That is like all marketing. That all has to do with marketing. So then through that, I kind of went and chose my minor to do that. And now I really like it. And it's something that, you know, I don't think I would have found if I hadn't, you know, gotten myself involved or tried to like draw the lines between those involvement areas.
So mine is about the same as Maddie. Sorry, there's some chat behind me. My power was out, same with Austin. So I had to come to the sub. But Boise wasn't too far from home, but it wasn't about like too close. And Boise also has all 4 seasons. So compared to the rain near Seattle, it was a way better atmosphere and just felt well better to be here. It's funny going back home now, it's like, oh, this is really depressing here. Boise is really awesome and it's great. And I actually came to Boise State actually on the pre-med track. So I was nowhere near criminal justice at all. Ended up failing chem and bio, which I was not happy about myself with, but ended up taking some criminal justice classes, and I actually loved them. Fell in love with the subject, fell in love with what I was learning. Actually started realizing that I wasn't making myself learn something. It was more of, I wanted to read this and I wanted to do that. And then it was the semester that I actually changed my major. I actually did the internship with the criminal defense attorney, and it kind of just stuck with me. I really enjoyed it.
Awesome. And yeah, bringing up the option to change a major, we know that on average, majority of incoming students do change their major from what they apply as. So for those of you in attendance who maybe have been admitted to Boise State and you're thinking about pursuing something else, you are able to change that through your My Boise State account at no penalty to you. So if you ever have questions, reach out to the admissions office and we can walk you through those steps. But you are not locked into whatever you applied as either back in October or even if you something clicks by the time you come to orientation and you want to change the day before, we do allow that. And jumping back over to school public service, Amanda, this might be geared to you again, but how hard is it to double major? And I know, and this is specifically asking with two SPS majors, but maybe just kind of in general, is there an option to double major in 4 years for students?
Totally. And that's a really an it depends question. But it definitely, at least within the school public service, so I can speak for our areas. I know a lot of majors as well, and like the College of Arts and Sciences, there's probably some business ones as well that have a lot of overlap. So it's really going to depend on if you're picking two majors that have a lot of overlap with one another, or two majors that have a lot of elective space. Because if majors have a lot of elective space, then everything you're taking for one major is counting as an elective for the other one you're doing. And everything you're taking for the other is counting as an elective for the other one. And so they usually fit really well together. So within SPS, I can pretty confidently say almost all of our majors, I would believe all of them can be feasible to do as double majors within a 4 year period, maybe having to take one or two summer classes, but nothing crazy that you would have to like pack summers or anything like that. A lot, again, will depend on if you already did some things coming in. So maybe you did some stuff in high school, and that's even going to help that cushion even more, that you're then not going to have to pack in as many things. And then I saw another question too, that criminal justice is our biggest major. So let's say you are thinking of, you know, double majoring in political science and criminal justice. That pairs well. And then you're learning two things that are really interchangeable and related together. And you might even have some faculty that overlap sometimes, because there really is just skill sets, global studies and political science, urban studies and criminal justice. There's so much pairing and so much value in learning the ways that they interact together. And that's just going to make you really marketable. So we do highly encourage double majoring at Boise State if it's feasible for the major you're doing.
And I'll just echo that and do a shout out to Amanda and her team at SPS, as well as the COBE advisors, who really are the experts. It might seem really intimidating to try to do two majors, you know, during your college career, or two majors and a minor or certificate. But we've got, again, professional advisors who are here to support you and walk you through that process and show you, you know, on paper what that looks like. So there's no mystery in that. You're never on your own when you come to either of these two colleges.
Awesome. And Kit, I know that you had mentioned the starting out as pre-business before really getting to pursue a specific area. Do you mind just explaining a little bit more on, I believe they're called the gateway courses, but just kind of how that works a little bit more in depth?
Sure. Even if you did go straight into the field you're interested in, you would still take all of those classes first, because a lot of times they're prerequisites to the major specific courses. So let's say you want to be a marketing major. You still have to take all those courses before you get there. Part of this is because, like I said before, we want students to kind of get a little taste of everything. But also part of it is a state board emphasis on, I don't even remember what it's called anymore, but where we try to make sure that students coming in, especially in the first couple of years, don't get stuck going down one road and then change their major and have to retake a bunch of extra stuff. So what that pre-business does is it allows you to you know, work your way towards a marketing degree, but then change and say, oh no, I want to go into supply chain management. You don't have to backtrack and do a bunch of extra coursework.
Awesome. And then I know we have a few minutes left, but I wanted to, a question for both SPS and College of Business. You'd mentioned internships, but what would be the process that students would go through if they wanted to pursue an internship? And are all of those paid opportunities? If not, are they getting academic credit? Whoever wants to start, Amanda or Andy, if you guys want to start and then pass it to Kit, that'd be awesome.
You want to go, Andy, or do you want me to?
No, you can start it and then I'll follow up and we'll pass it to Kit.
Yeah, so I'm glad you're asking that question because, again, internships are invaluable experiences. But you also, let's say you have kids or work full-time, you don't have to do them for any of our majors. So I just want to put that out there. But we do encourage it if possible. And if that's something you're wanting to do, all of our majors within the School of Public Service have a faculty member who is dedicated to being the internship coordinator for that program. And so they really help walk you through the whole process, how to enroll in it, how to find it, what one is really going to gear best towards what you're wanting to do and what your goals are, how to get credit for it, all of those. And so you can take one freshman or sophomore year. It's not as encouraged just because you probably don't have as much under your belt. And so you're going to go in pretty leery of how to do it. They might not be giving you a lot of hands-on tasks to do, but junior or senior year is when we really, really encourage it and when it's really going to count for credit for your program and for your major. And then you would just let us know you're interested. We'll connect you. If you want to know really specific ones, I would just recommend doing a Google search because all of our majors are so different. But if you Google Boise State and then whatever major, so Boise State Criminal Justice Internship, I just tested it out because I saw this question. It works for every single one of our majors within the school. So Boise State, the major and the word internship, and you'll find a ton of information about where students commonly intern for our programs and stuff like that. But great question.
Yeah, and I'll just say as well that, you know, while our internships are not required, like Amanda said, we highly encourage it. It really is part and parcel of what we're trying to do in the School of Public Service. It all revolves around what I mentioned earlier about, you know, signature experiential learning pieces that take your theories and concepts that you learn in your discipline or disciplines and apply that to the real world. I mean, look at Riley's, you know, internship experience in criminal justice in the School of Public Service. I mean, there's nothing better than to get that experience. And sometimes, you know, we talk to our students and they'll take an internship and say, you know what, I'm really glad I did that. I was really looking at fill in the blank, probation as a career. And you know what, I don't like it. And that is really good to know while you're still in school. Others say, you know what, I've just networked and I figured out this is what I want to do in my early career and I'm going for it. And now I've got a bunch of connections that I made while I was a student at Boise State University. So we highly encourage it. And I know our friends in business and economics do the same thing.
I just wanted to add, sorry, Kit, you can do up to 12 credits of internship towards a degree at Boise State. So you can do lots of different ones. And then also some might be paid. Maybe even you have a part-time job and you feel it really relates to political science. You could check with our internship coordinator if they'd allow it, but not all are paid. So it would kind of depend.
Yeah.
So we, in the College of Business and Economics, each major has an internship coordinator and they have a package of internships that they can, you know, share with students, and students are interested, they want to do it. Students can go out and find their own internship and then bring it to the coordinators and say, you know, will this work for this credit? A lot of the majors have a limit of 3, I think a few limit it to 6 credits. But we also have, and most of those I think are unpaid. However, we do have a paid internship program called Bronco Corps for summer internships. That is, the funding for that is provided by a generous donor. And so they are specifically for nonprofit organizations. So a lot of great work is happening, and that's all facilitated through our Career Center.
Awesome. And then Maddie and Riley, just really quick, I wanted to have you guys kind of wrap it up. Do you mind just sharing what's been your favorite class or classroom experience, I guess, in your time at Boise State?
Yeah, I can go first. I think one of the big things is you come into college and you expect to walk into a classroom with a lot of people. And I don't think this was mentioned yet, but it's really a 30-to-1 ratio. I mean, especially going into like last year and this year, I've only had maybe 20 students in my class. So it's really small and it's really great because it doesn't feel any different. The learning environment is still the same, like what you've grown up in. One of my favorite classes within this, I'm actually taking it right now, and it's criminal law. And I absolutely love it. It's mostly you're learning about criminal law as a whole, but you're also studying cases and how they work and what defines them and stuff like that. And I love it.
For me, I think in business, we work a lot in groups, which is something that I didn't totally expect, but there's a lot of like team presentations and stuff that goes on. And I think that especially in my 300 and 400 level classes, having that like group kind of atmosphere has been really fun. I've actually met a lot of like really amazing people through the different groups that I've been involved in. And I'm still like really good friends with them. And I have them in my like other upper division classes. But business 301 that I had last semester, it was a super fun class with my group. And then our teacher like knew everyone's names. And so it felt super personal. And like, even in my 400 level classes, like they do get smaller, but we're still in like a 50 person class. And like the professor like knows everyone's names and tries to make that personal connection, which has been really nice.
Awesome. Yeah. And Riley, thanks for mentioning that. We're actually this year, average class size for Boise State is 29 students. So yeah, really lucky that students get like Amanda was talking about, a lot of really personalized opportunities with their advisors, with their professors, with other students. So, well, with that, I'm going to share my screen just for a couple quick slides to wrap it up. But I really appreciate all of our attendees, all of our panelists taking the time. Panelists, if you don't mind, just turn your cameras off one more time. I'll wrap up with just a couple opportunities to connect with us and to visit campus. Both of our students actually mentioned that they are tour guides. So if you ever wanted to come onto campus and get a guided campus tour, we'd love to show you around. We have Monday through Friday daily tours, a bunch of Saturday options, bigger programs like Discover Boise State, where you could hear from all of our academic programs. So you can see that link there. We also have an academic appointment request form. So if you didn't get your questions answered tonight and you wanted to set up an appointment with an academic rep from our different colleges, and we can definitely help get that set up. And then we do virtual future student sessions, which just kind of more of an information session about Boise State. We do those. We have one coming up on December 7th, and then we'll have our spring availability coming up after the new year as well. So definitely feel free to either reach out to our admissions office for opportunities to visit campus. It is also on the Boise State homepage. And then you can always scan this QR code as well. That will take you to a quick little website that has you fill out just kind of where you're coming from, and that'll show you who your specific admissions counselor is. People like myself, that's what we're here for, is to help answer any of those questions that you have and get you on your way to hopefully becoming a Boise State Bronco. So with that, we really appreciate you coming. I know it's 8 o'clock Mountain, 7 o'clock Pacific, so I want to try to end right on time. But if you have any follow-up questions, please reach out to the admissions office, or hopefully you can follow that link to set up an academic virtual opportunity as well. So thanks to our panelists and to our attendees. With that, have a great rest of your night. And as always, go Broncos.